I once saw a picture of an old Rolls-Royce taking part in the Beijing to Paris endurance rally. Little did I know back then that the guys at Goodwood would actually make a car that's a lot more suitable for such an adventure. But they did, and Rolls-Royce's first 4x4 has been on the roads and probably very, very rarely off the roads for several years now. Yes, today I'm sitting in a Rolls-Royce Cullinan, and it is phenomenal. But what's more, this isn't just any Cullinan. This one is Black Badge, meaning it's more potent and driver-oriented than the standard car, and it also comes from the Inspired by Fashion collection by Rolls-Royce Bespoke. A Cullinan, and especially a Black Badge one, is one of the models of Rolls-Royce where the owners predominantly drive rather than being chauffeured around. And I can see why. This car puts me in such a good mood. It gives me a feeling of complete serenity, like I don't have a single worry in this world. And I suspect that's something a lot of very high net worth individuals would be after. One of the key reasons for that, of course, is the quietness in this car. It comes with about 130 kilograms of soundproofing, foam in the tires, double glazing, and the result is quite impressive. The car is very quiet. I've been doing about 80 right now, and I can even whisper. What's more, then there is the suspension, air suspension of course, and there is a stereo camera scanning the road ahead and adjusting the dampers just before you hit a pothole or an uneven part of the road. However, here is a curvy stretch of road ahead, and I'm gonna press this low button. Low means sporty in Rolls-Royce language. And unleash the beast under the front hood. So the car is very capable, but honestly, every time there is a corner ahead of me, I'm about to shit my pants because this thing weighs 2.7 tons and I can definitely tell. Talking about the beast under the hood, this is a V12, silky smooth, naturally balanced. It has a huge displacement of 6.75 liters and it generates 600 horsepower and 900 newton meters of torque. This is enough to accelerate the car to 100 kilometers per hour in 5.2 seconds. But the most important bit here is the way the power is delivered, because it is so subtle yet infinitely powerful. It's great. That's the spirit of Rolls-Royce. Let's go to the Inspired by Fashion bit. This is a glimpse into the infinite possibilities of Bespoke. Here in particular, we have a wild berry exterior with a single coach line finished in Arctic white. And you probably already know that, but I'm gonna say it anyway because it's astonishing. The coach line was hand-painted. And what I find quite interesting is that this was done using a brush made of squirrel hair. Other than that, the styling. You may not like it, but there's no denying it's imposing. You may even say that it's a bit ugly, but it's timeless ugly, and that works very well on a car like a Rolls-Royce. But honestly, I think that it does look like a proper Rolls-Royce, and I can see the heritage of the brand in this styling, and frankly, I quite like that. What I like even more is the interior of the Cullinan. I've stumbled upon pieces of art in museums, of jewelry, and actually the interior of the Cullinan makes me feel the same way. It's like I'm not even supposed to touch it. It is spectacular. It kind of makes me feel that I would like to have been born in a very working class family, just like Victoria Beckham's.
We're very working class.
Be honest.
I am being honest.
What car did your dad drive you to school in?
So my dad did.
No, one answer.
My dad, well.
No.
Okay, what in car? The 80s, what? My dad had a Rolls Royce.
Thank you.
Here, the interior is finished in Arctic white, navy blue, and peony pink for the accents, stitching, and piping. But with Bespoke, you can go truly bonkers with the colors. The veneer is technical carbon, which in essence is naked with carbon fiber, and it has 6 coats of lacquer, and of course, it's hand polished. We also have the skylight, which shows the stars over the Goodwood factory, and the finest leather everywhere. Even the indicator stalk is wrapped in a dead European bull. By the way, at Rolls-Royce, they don't use cow leather as they are prone to having stretch marks unlike bulls. That's gotta be sexist. In the back, the Cullinan welcomes us with its rear-hinged doors, which make entering and exiting the car a tad easier. Quite uniquely, the rear quarter windows are located in your line of sight, which to a royalty may be reminiscent of a Rolls-Royce Phantom 6, for example. With my experience, this reminds me of a London cab, minus certain smells, of course. However, nothing else here feels like a cab or any normal car for that matter. We have the partition window for extra noise isolation and, more importantly, the immersive seating option, giving us these separate two seats in the back with a large central console. Right here, we have a fridge and glasses for your champagne. You can also put your bottle of champagne over there. Then, if you feel like something stronger, you had a bad day or something, you can put your whiskey into this decanter, and of course it comes with the whiskey glasses. If you are wondering where you're gonna put them, we open this and we have, for these glasses, we can put them here. But if you are feeling like celebrating something with some bubbly, then we put the glasses like this and they are stable when you travel. What's more, over here we have a controller for the infotainment system, so I can control the navigation, all the options, the media and everything else. And if I get bored at some point, I can first of all open my picnic table, have some lunch, and then of course turn on the infotainment system for the rear passenger, which also shows a lot of different information, the maps and everything else. And with all this luxury, there's one button you normally wouldn't expect to find here, off-road. So there's just this one button, you press it and you are ready to escape from reality. It's been a long day, so I'm gonna head back and enjoy the serenity and good mood this car puts me in. However, before that, let me show you something, because this Cullinan has one more trick up its sleeve. This car is equipped with the optional Cullinan viewing suite. So I'm just gonna take these seats out, sit down here for a bit, enjoy the views, and daydream of what might be.